So, listen to that noise. That's a noise I've been waiting to hear for a very long time. That is the call of the Indri, the largest species of lemur. And they sound pretty close.
So this morning we are in the reserve of Anol Mazawacha, which is much smaller than that of Andasibe Mantadia. We were unsuccessful at finding the injuries yesterday, but we are here today with hopes of finding some.
Anol Mazawacha Reserve has been especially established for the Indri, but is also home to various other species of lemur. We started off our trek by following a small troop of common brown lemur, foraging in the canopy. However, unfortunately, this wasn't the species of lemur we were looking for. As we began walking deeper into the forest, we began hearing distant cries. We knew we were getting closer to the Indri, as the cries were getting louder. It eventually involved us leaving the path, and with their loud noises, finding them wasn't all that difficult.
Found them. So the troop of Indri are just above us right now. They were just doing a call to establish territories. It's very loud and can be heard several kilometres away.
It was still relatively early in the morning and the Indris weren't being all that active. They remained mostly in the lower vegetation, feeding on their main food source, leaves. The Indris are perfectly adapted for life in the trees, and seldom come down to the forest floor. You'll find that with many other primates, primarily apes, most of the power is in their arms. However, for lemurs, especially the Indri, all the power is in their legs. Indris are capable of leaping astonishing distances. The Indri family were now beginning to be a bit more active, and as they started leaping from tree to tree, it made them more difficult to follow. Indris prefer to live in small family groups. They are also monogamous, meaning a male and female Indri will pair for life until one of them dies. The Indri also holds a place in many local taboos and is seen as sacred. One of its origin stories derives from two brothers living in a forest, and one brother eventually decided to leave the forest and go cultivate land. The brother who was left in the forest then became the Indri, and every day he would cry out for his brother, begging for his return. As the weather began to improve, the Indris were heading up higher into the canopy in order to make the most of the sunlight, as well as forage for more leaves and fruit. However, another Indri family can be heard howling in the distance. This then prompts the Indri to perform its most famous piece of behaviour. The Indris head to an open part of the canopy and cry out their song for the whole forest to hear. However, unfortunately, this spectacular animal hasn't got the best future ahead. Rapid deforestation and forest fragmentation has made the Indri critically endangered. The Indri population is no more than 10,000 individuals, and over the next few decades, their population could decrease by up to 80%. So could it be that the ghostly cries of the Indri, echoing over the eastern hills of Madagascar, could soon be but a thing of the past? And that brings us to the end of our adventures in Madagascar. We've travelled through the spectacular eastern rainforests, from the southeast to the northeast, as well as exploring the hostile, dry and spiny forests of the south, meeting a vast array of spectacular encounters that call this biological wonderland home. I know you heard it from those
I've heading your way.
It's certainly a privilege that few will get to see. I can happily say it is an absolutely spectacular one.